This is Jared Horak for the runawayhorse.com. It is Thursday, April 18th, 2019. All of the Kentucky Derby 2019 prep races have now been run. And I'm going to look at, now that we got a good idea of which horses are going to run in the Kentucky Derby, I'm going to take a look at the top five most likely winners of the 2019 Kentucky Derby in alphabetical order. And we're going to start with Game Winner. A Game Winner was your two-year-old champion. He was 4-for-4 last year for trainer Bob Baffert. And his schedule's gotten messed up this year. He was supposed to return in the San Felipe Stakes in March, but they canceled the San Felipe. Santa Anita was having problems with their main track. He had to come back instead of March 9th. He had to wait a week and come back and run on March 16th at Oaklawn Park in one of the divisions of the Revel Stakes. And he ended up missing by a nose. Omaha Beach just beat him. It was a solid effort in his first start. And then they shipped him back to California. He returned 3 weeks later to run in the Santa Anita Derby. Once again, he finished second. Roadster beat him there, his stablemate. So he's lost both of his starts this year, but he ran well both times. And considering his schedule was off, you know, his workout pattern was off. He didn't run in the races that he was supposed to run in. And then they had to wheel him back in 3 weeks. So now everything should be go for the Kentucky Derby. He will now have 4 weeks between starts, and he's finally running in a race that he's been pointing to for quite some time, since winning the Breeders' Cup Juvenile last fall. And his regular rider, Joel Rosario, is going to stay put. He's got running style versatility. He's got the class. There's a lot to like about Game Winner. It's just a question, is he really better as a three-year-old now, because he didn't win either of his starts this year. His speed figures aren't spectacular, but they're solid, they're competitive, and he looks like a solid threat in the Kentucky Derby. The next one we're going to look at is a Game Winner stablemate, Improbable. Now, Improbable, also trained by Bob Baffert, now he shipped to Oaklawn Park twice. Now, Bob Baffert originally said prior to the San Felipe, he was going to run a Game Winner and Improbable against each other in the San Felipe because he didn't want to ship to Oaklawn Park twice. After they canceled the San Felipe, both horses shipped to Oaklawn Park. Improbable ran in the other division, the first division of the Rebel Stakes, and he ended up finishing second. He had a wide trip. He took the lead. He was run down by Long Range Toddy. Now, he had to ship back to Oaklawn for the Arkansas Derby, so he went back and shipped a second time. Once again, California horse beat him. Omaha Beach beat him by a length. It was a solid effort for Improbable. And now he's going to get a new rider for the Kentucky Derby. So Improbable's going to have to get a new rider now. And he's one that I think he can improve in the Derby. Irata Ortiz Jr. is going to ride him for the first time. Both starts this year, again, he wasn't pointing to the Rebel originally. His second start last time in the Arkansas Derby. Muddy track, inside post. The inside track place was not the place to be at the inside at Oaklawn that day. And he was able to move off of the rail nicely and set a decent trip. But he was fractious at the gate, first time in blinkers. A lot of things were against Improbable, but he ran well anyway. So he's one that I could easily see moving up. He won the Low South Futurity last year, and it looked like he wanted to run all day. Look for him in the Derby maybe to run his best career race in his third start of the year. Omaha Beach is the next one to look at. This one, it took him a while to break his maiden. He was finishing second. He was disappointing. They tried him on turf. Then they moved him to the main track. I think that was the key. He broke his maiden by more than 9 lengths in the slop at Santa Anita at 7 furlongs. And then he jumped into the Rebel Stakes, his first stakes race, facing winners and facing Game Winner. And he was able to win that race. So that was an excellent effort from Omaha Beach. Then he shipped back to Oaklawn Park a second time. And he ended up beating Improbable last time. Again, a wet track. So two of his last three wins were on wet tracks. He handles a fast track. He's got that early pressing versatility, and he got the jump on Game Winner and Improbable in his last two wins. So if he can do that in the Kentucky Derby, if he can get up on the pace, get the jump on the late runners, he could be interesting. He has that turf pedigree that can do well at Churchill Downs, and he's bred to get the mile and a quarter distance. Mike Smith chose him over Roadster. He's going to be your favorite. He's a solid contender, but no room for error. It's not like he's way better than anybody else. He's not Justify. He's not American Pharoah. These horses are evenly matched, this core group of contenders in the Derby. Roadster's the next one to look at. Another runner for trainer Bob Baffert. The third Bob Baffert runner we're going to talk about, Florin Giroux, is going to ride. Now, he's got running style versatility. He's one that I liked last year on the road to the Derby. He didn't get to really run in any of the points races, but he was on my Kentucky Derby list last September, And he won his debut. I love that effort from the inside post. It's tough to win from the inside post, these young horses. He was able to look very professional winning his debut at Del Mar. And then he came back in the Del Mar Futurity. He was favored against Game Winner. Game Winner beat him there. He was third. Now, in the off season, he had surgery to correct a breathing problem. Then he came back this year in a one-mile race, optional claiming company. He looked great winning that one, defeating Nolo Contesto. And then he came back in the Santa Anita Derby, and he was patiently ridden by Mike Smith, and he rallied to beat Game Winner at the end. Looks like he wants to run on further. A lot of upside here, and he's had 4 weeks between starts, and he's lightly raced. So he's a solid contender in the Derby. Finally, Tacitus. Tacitus will round out the five horses that I'm looking at. For trainer Bill Mott, outstanding pedigree. Tappet, the sire, he has sired numerous Belmont Stakes winners. Close Hatches is his dam, multiple graded stakes winner. So for Bill Mott, Jubmon Farm, this is a solid horse. Jose Ortiz is going to ride this one, and he's a strong finisher. He's run two times this year. He broke his maiden last year, and then he showed up in the Tampa Bay Derby in his first start as off of a layoff, first start against winners. And he won that race, so that was an excellent effort. And then he jumped into the Wood Memorial. And in the Wood Memorial at Aqueduct, a fine effort there as well. He was able to rally from off the pace. He didn't have the smoothest trip, but he overcame some trouble and he won there. So if the pace heats up, Tacitus is one to look for in the stretch in the Kentucky Derby. And speaking of the Kentucky Derby, my full card analysis at therunawayhorse.com, my full card that I offer every year from Churchill Downs will be available at therunawayhorse.com Kentucky Derby Week. In the last 13 Triple Crown races, I've given out 10 winners in the last 13 Triple Crowns. So winning tickets in 10 of the last 13 Triple Crowns, if you've bought my analysis, I've had some good payoffs of $2,000 superfectas. I had like a $400 exacta 1 year. So good payoffs, good wagering strategies with that product. And you can find that at therunawayhorse.com, Kentucky Derby Week. That will wrap up this week's video. I'll be back next week to look at more of the Kentucky Derby 2019 contenders.